found out about hospice actually through my cousin, an English cousin of mine, who told me that there's a charity in England that may be interested in getting behind a home that we had found and we found in bad shape. For a while it had been actually with a French religious order, and that for different reasons couldn't move forward. But the idea of Hospice of Hope was not new to me, because my former employer, Sir David Frost, his wife was the Duchess of Norfolk. So, and the patron of Hospice of Hope in the UK is the Duchess of Norfolk, so this was actually his daughter. And so in a way it was an interesting and satisfying full circle, because it came from my family to my former employer, to his wife, to a hospice organization that I knew before. The first meeting with Graham was delightful. He came to Cannes to visit my father, where my father was elderly and finishing a book. And he explained what he wanted to do in his very kind of self-effacing, casual manner, which appealed to my father, because my father, though he's Romanian, was actually educated mostly in England and at university. So he felt comfortable with Graham. He liked the idea of charity, and it wasn't the first kind of charity he had been involved with. Earlier, prior to hospice, my father had started a charity for gifted Romanian children. That is to say, kids in Romania from all over the country who would be sent to the United States in the summertime to study at schools for gifted children. So in a way, we were looking after those who were lucky in life and those people who were less lucky in life. I think that we wanted an organization that could make things happen. I think a lot of people have good intentions, a lot of people have good ideas, but very few actually can make things happen. And I felt that in the ideas that Graham and later Alex had put forward, that these gentlemen could deliver. They had done it in other countries. They were the kind of people that we felt comfortable with. They had a track record. We actually went to the hospice in Brasov and looked at it. And I remember walking in on the inside and we saw all these awards. So it's the best European hospice. We saw the faces of the staff. We saw the kids. And we said, well, they seem like they're the kind of organization can put this together. And for us, that means a lot. They could make it happen. It was a remarkable feat to see it finally open. I'm sorry my father wasn't there to witness this, but my mother was there. And she and our family were very happy to see this finally take root, and to see kids coming in, and to see everything painted. We watched it step by step each of the years, and we saw it grow in front of our eyes, almost like a child. And then it came to the moment where the people that were behind it, whether they be staff, administrators, nurses, donors, they were all there. And it just felt that this was like a second beginning. We had a first beginning when we got the house back, I guess a second beginning when we gave it to the French Catholic Church, and now a third beginning. So three-time lucky, I'd say. I think that the world is changing a lot. And I think that the role of government is diminishing, whether that's in the United States or in Romania or in Western Europe. On the one hand, it's economic, because the governments don't seem to have the willpower or the means to take care of some of their social responsibilities. I know in the United States that people have a habit of giving. Just last night, there was a lottery in the United States for $1.6 billion. That's what the winner would get. And underneath, they're running an online survey of how people would use the money. One was save it, one was spend it, one was donate it. The donate it was about the same as the other two categories. So that idea that you give something back because you've been lucky is a very deeply rooted idea in the United States. If you go to hospitals in Boston, if you go to universities across the United States, you will see that those universities are supported heavily by people who did well in life and felt they had to give something back. And I think that mentality, which is maybe not so common in Western Europe, where they think, oh, the state ought to take care of it, they ought to do it, that's why we pay taxes, I think is a outdated point of departure. I think people have to say, listen, let's get behind this, let's do it ourselves, and not rely on the state, because the states, not only do they don't do the money, they don't have the money, but they don't perform particularly efficiently, and they don't perform well in many, many cases. My view is that NGOs and hospices are providing a huge service to this country. And I think it's vital that that continue. I think that it doesn't take much to see the hurting parts of Romania. You can drive 10 miles from here, 10 kilometers from here. You can drive to the end of the driveway of Copacen and see it there. So it doesn't take much imagination. It just takes someone to open their eyes. And without the hospice of hope, there'd be all those more children and their families who would be suffering, mostly silently, I guess.